algorithmic trading for complete beginners. And today we're starting a new section in our course, which is going to be about system design and trading functions, sending orders, working with prices, and so on. So this is a very exciting part, and I'm really glad that you've made it this far. We're going to be delving deeper into the actual Forex market and finally start to do some basic algorithmic trading. In today's tutorial, we're not going to actually code anything right away. We're going to focus on understanding how systems are designed and what basically goes into the foundation of a programming system or an algorithmic trading system. And I think it is an important part, and it illustrates, this tutorial will illustrate that with any kind of algorithmic system development, you first have to sit down and understand what you want to create. And sometimes I even recommend writing these things down on a paper for yourself, so that you, when you do start coding, you understand exactly what the requirements are and what the algorithm will look like. Because clear requirements will always make your programming experience much more pleasurable and seamless, and you won't have to stop and rethink things along the way. So here I have a euro dollar chart open in front of me, and pretty lucky that today is actually the weekend. It's Saturday, so the markets are not working, and we're going to take advantage of that. So the prices are still, and we're going to just discuss what would happen, what we'd want to do if we could trade now. But because the markets are still, we won't have this problem of the price moving around. So we're kind of discussing a freeze frame of the market. This is a bar chart, and I'm just going to change it to a line graph so that it's easier to discuss, so there's less clutter on the chart. Right now the ask price is 1.3608 for euro dollar, and the bid price is 1.3606. So the ask price, I'm sure you're aware of this, but I'll just recap. The ask price is always higher than the bid price, and basically the ask price is the price that it's the dearer price. So if you want to buy euros for dollars, you're going to have to do it at the ask price. So for every 1 euro, you're going to have to pay 1.3608 American dollars. And conversely, the bid price is always less than ask price. It's the cheaper of the two. So basically, if you want to sell euros for dollars, you're going to get this amount of dollars for every euro. And the difference between them is called the spread. So that basically, in essence, the spread is what disadvantage you are, or that price you pay for conducting these transactions. And that's an important part, because in our algorithms, we're going to have to take into account both the ask and the bid price and understand where to use which one. Let's see what let's try to understand what kind of system we would possibly want to design. In this particular instance, we can't really, from what we see, we can't really tell whether the price is going to go up or is going to go down. So for argument's sake, let's suggest that the price is going to go up. So what would we need in a algorithmic trading system that is going to buy euros against dollars? Because the price is going up, we want to buy euros cheap, and then when the price goes up, we want to sell them. So first of all, we're going to have to understand how far do we think the price is going to go up by. And let's, for example, say there's going to be 10 pips that the price is going to increase by. And so basically, it will get to the level of 1.3616. And if you notice here, I'm using the bid price. So how this works is, if we want to buy euros for dollars, we're going to have to use the ask price to buy them. And for every 1 euro, we're going to have to pay $1.3608. But then if we want to sell them, we're going to be selling at the bid price. So this gap over here is, it's already our disadvantage. It's already what we lose just by initiating this transaction. And therefore we have to take into account. So if we want to earn 10 pips on the movement, upward movement of euro dollar, we're going to have to base our calculations on the bid price. So the initial transaction will occur at the ask price, but further on, we're going to be dealing with the bid price, and we will be trying to close a transaction at the bid price. So if we want 10 pips, it's going to be 1.3616. So that's the first part, and you'd think that that is the full extent of the trading system, but that wouldn't be correct, because we also have to take into account a possible downward movement, and we have to protect our position from very high losses. So let's see, what is the maximum that we can afford to lose? Let's say it's also 10 pips. So in that case, we need to set a stop loss at bid minus 10 pips, which is 1.3596. So as you can see, a simple trading system that suggests an upward movement has to have certain factors built into it. It has to open a position at the ask price, then it has to have a take profit at the bid price plus 10 pips, and has to have a stop loss at the bid price minus 10 pips. Now let's look at a different situation where, for example, here on the Euro Canadian dollar, where we see more of the chart, and we've made some we can make some we can do some analysis and try to understand the future movements and predict exactly where it's going to move, where the chart's, the price is going to move. So here I've marked the ask and bid price, and here you can see the difference is a bit higher. It's actually 8 pips between the ask and bid, and that's because this is not a Euro Canadian dollar, is not a major payer. It's a cross. So here we can see that there's been a substantial move upward, and the price has reached this level of uncertainty around 1.460, so it's just crossed it. And previous experience suggests that sometimes a price can turn around at this level and go backwards, and so that's what we're going to bet on. We're going to suggest, we're going to speculate that the price is going to go down from here, and is going to reach a certain level, and we're going to try to capitalize on that. So here I've identified a level where there was another uncertainty at 1.4545 or somewhere around there, where historically the price has experienced turning points or some kind of uncertainty around where it's going to move. So what we will do is we'll use that level, and we'll expect the price to go down to that level, but we will exit the position just before the price gets there, and that will put us on the safe side. So we'll exit the position at the blue line, and then that way we can avoid getting into this, getting close to this level where the price may turn around and may not turn around. So exiting at the blue line is being on the safe side. So if we have a sell position, which will open here at the bid price, then the take profit we're going to set at 1.4555. At the same time, as in the previous example, we need a stop loss. And for sell positions, stop loss goes up to the top. So here we see a level where the price has previously turned around. So what we'll do is we will speculate that if the price does go upward against our position, there is a probability that it will actually turn around at the yellow line and then go down like it did over here and reach our take profit, so we can actually still make money. So in that case, we would want to set the stop loss above the yellow line, so we don't lose this opportunity of the price actually turning around. And that says that means that the stop loss would be set at around 1.4645. So in this case, you see that the take profit is around 50 pips, and the stop loss is around 40 pips, or basically, to be more correct, we have to be working with the ask price. So the take profit is 57 pips, stop loss is around 33 pips. So to sum up, this strategy, even though it is similar to the previous one which we discussed here, these two strategies have different requirements. In the first strategy, we were choosing an entry level based on the market price, and then we were setting the stop loss and take profit and stop loss based on a fixed number of pips, which was 10 pips for both. In this strategy, this approach is different. We are still using the market price to enter, but to exit, we're not using a fixed stop loss or take profit. To exit, we're actually using prices, price levels, which we see on the market, and we're moving away a little bit from them. So that means that the algorithmic trading systems will be similar, but will differ from each other in the sense that the parameters of these systems, in the first case, it'll be the levels or the absolute values, the distances of the stop loss and take profit from the market price. But in the second situation, the input parameters will actually be fixed prices which the trader chooses based on his analysis of the currency pair. So that's in a nutshell what algorithmic trading system design is about, and of course it gets more complex and more involved and has much more aspects to it, but these are the basics, and I hope you found that helpful, and maybe you could look at some of the charts in your trading platform and try to understand what strategy you would apply as in each situation. And in the next tutorial, we're going to look at how we can actually turn this logic into code and how we can create scripts which will implement this logic for us. And I think you will find the next tutorial very exciting. So that's it for this tutorial.